In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. When a child is born, we are full of hopes and dreams for this new life. We marvel at the wonder of a baby. When I baptize a child or a baby, I invite the families to think about what their hopes and dreams are for this child, and to know that God has a hope for this child, and we look for the living out, the realization of that hope as this child lives God's calling in their lives. We wonder intently about what a newborn child will become. And such is the depth of our wondering that it is part of the myriad of things which are so heartbreakingly hard about the death of a baby or a child. For in that moment, we feel not only the weight of the loss of love, but the weight of those hopes and dreams which died with the child. For the birth of a child is indeed a sign of hope, a sign of hope for the future, belief that the future will continue and be good. We study a newborn intently, looking for signs in their face and in their hands of what their future will hold. Anna and Simeon, I imagine, had long studied the faces of every child that had been brought to the temple. They too were looking for hope, for the fulfillment of hopes and dreams, for signs of salvation and hope for a new future. And in this unassuming poor couple's child, they find the hope for which they had been searching. We heard this same gospel a few weeks ago, just after Christmas, and on that occasion I spoke about the role of Anna as someone who sees what others miss. That still remains true, but today I want to look at Simeon with his beautiful song of praise to God, an acknowledgement both of what he sees in his arms and also that in this moment his time has come. Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel. We can gloss over what is happening here for Simeon in the excitement of the presentation and the realization that this child is light for all the world. Simeon is proclaiming hope, hope for a future, but hope for a future he will not see. For in this moment he knows that his time has come to pass on the baton of hope to another. Simeon, however, has spent a lifetime believing in, trusting in, and looking for the realization of this hope. And it is in this moment that he trusts in a future which he will not see, but in which he believes. He trusts in a future in which there is salvation and light for all, and in which the glory of God is made known in the vulnerability and innocence of a child. Simeon, like Anna, had spent a lifetime waiting in hope, waiting with hope, trusting in the promise that he would not see death until he had seen the Lord's Messiah. And so it's a bittersweet moment. Simeon sees, and Simeon, in catching this glimpse of the glory of God, knows that his mortality will finally take hold. But above all, Simeon, in this moment of passing from life in this world to life in another, proclaims words of hope for a world which yearns for redemption and for a lifetime investing in hope. The rewards for Simeon and Anna, we might say, are eternal. Where do we invest in hope? A new school year has started. If you're on Facebook, you could have hardly missed all the photos that have gone up of children starting new schools, beginning school, beginning a new phase of learning. And in these photos, there is unbridled joy, not necessarily from the children returning to school, but you can hear the words of pride and joy in those who've shared the photos, for in these young people, they see hope. This Saturday at 5 p.m, we'll have our annual Blessing of the Backpack service as we pray God's blessing on those who are starting in places of learning this year and those who will support and nurture them. I often say to teachers, as I did a few days ago to the staff at Newcastle Grammar School across the road, that to be a teacher is to be a person of intrinsic hope, because their vocation is to selflessly invest in the future, a future which perhaps they will never see. And yet, not seeing this future, not knowing this future, not knowing what it will bring, does not prevent them from believing and investing in this young life in their care. We do this as parents too, as godparents, as grandparents, as aunts and uncles and cousins and friends and neighbours. We do this as the body of Christ, the church, when we celebrate baptism. Live as a disciple of Christ, we say to the newly baptized. Finish the race. We do not know what race they will run, for it is their own. We do not know what shape their discipleship will take, for it is shaped by God. But we do know, and we do hope, that God will be made known through them. God will be made known to them. And we trust and hope that as all these things come to be, that they will be signs of hope for a future generation. We invest in hope. Hope for a future we will not see, but a future in which we know the glory of God will still be made known. This year, it seems that we're pondering the future with a new poignancy. This time last year, COVID-19 tales were clouds on the horizon of a bushfire-scarred landscape and a smoke-stained sky. We waded through last year, sometimes wondering if it was all hopeless, if this was all folly, not knowing what the future would hold, but in the end, never giving up on hope. And so we find ourselves, as always, standing at the cusp of this new year, these new beginnings, and wondering what lies in store. But in all our wondering, our greatest gift is to be like that of Simeon and Anna, to invest in hope for the future. Where will you invest your hope? Where will we, as the people of God, invest hope? Where will we, like Simeon and Anna, be prepared to name hope in our midst and to proclaim it? Where will we be unashamed to name God, who is our hope now and always, and to share the light of that hope with those who feel that all is hopeless? And where will we, like Simeon and Anna, invest in a future we will not see, but hoping and trusting in God, who is the redemption of all, light for the world, which darkness can never overcome. Amen.